Hello, Icaros.
I swear on my life, any lives I will take from others, I will not fail the cosmos again.
Thank you.
Τίμου Ινίρος. Τέθηκε εν το πόλεμο. Αυτή λέγει ότι η μητήρ σου είναι δούλη. Είναι φυγατή.
Ο άντρες και γυναίκες να με φέρει.
Αλλά εμπόρου δείτε είναι τα πράγματα.
Εγκαλώνει με θεά, αγλαώνει με, τεχνώνει και πολύ ως με.
Should be extra careful in this area. Just waiting for a chance to perch, were you? activated. Synchronizing retransmission chronosity. Contact engaged.
Ready for sail!
Commander! We've been waiting for you! Thank you.
ready? Come on. Come on. Let's go.
I should try to stay out of sight.
have the best prizes around.
I'll see you soon.
You must be the one Pericles sent.
I am. He said there was an ostracism vote, but didn't tell me what I'm here to do.
Of course he didn't. That's what I'm for.
If someone is exiled, can they return?
If they do, they'll be punished.
What does someone have to do to be ostracized?
Anyone seen as a threat to the city or the people is enough. And then it is up to the vote. Some have been ostracized for simply being more disliked than the person they're up against.
What's my role in this?
The votes have already been cast. We don't have long before they're counted. Take the Ostraca in this bag and exchange them with the ones currently under guard.
You want me to rig the ostracism?
Pericles does. And he has his reasons, I'm sure. Bring me the bag you took from the room, and I'll take care of the rest.
No one will see me go in or out. Stay here.
Thank you. Share it to you.
Let me know if you need anything else.
There'll be trouble if I'm spotted here. I set sail soon. I want you with me when I do.
I wouldn't mind learning some of their strategy, but they have a turn for luck. Great rewards that can lead us to victory.
Watch where you're going!
Thank you. πάρουμε του ελαίου σου για την ψυχή ως προσφορά.
Goods from all over the Greek world. You wouldn't think the city was besieged by an army of Spartans. It's done.
You work quickly.
What are you going to do with them?
Dump them in a well. It looks like the official has arrived.
I apologize for the delay. There was evidence someone attempted to tamper with the boats. Don't worry. The Ostraca are all accounted for. The votes were counted, and Anaxagoras is to be ostracized!
Be slow to fall into friendship, but once you do, continue firm and constant. It will be more difficult for me now that Anaxagoras must leave Athens. We were quite close, although he and Pericles were much closer. It's strange, Pericles wasn't here today to defend him.
You said you were close.
He was like a mentor to me. Many of my best thoughts came to fruition through our conversations.
Would Pericles normally defend someone?
A good friend? Of course. Yet, Anaxagoras seems pleased with the result. This day has brought more questions than answers. Ask anyone and they'll tell you Socrates. But a name gives you nothing. Our actions determine who we are, and every action has its pleasures and its price. With that said, then, who do you claim to be?
My name is Cassandra.
And still, I don't feel I know you. Perhaps I can find out who you are a different way.
You want to know me?
Knowledge is the one good in this world. Surely you agree.
Of course. Knowledge drives everything I do.
Then we are the same in that way.
Knowledge of when to attack, what weapon to use, or when to use reason instead of violence.
We seem to put our love of knowledge into practice quite differently.
I use it how I need to.
You are clearly someone who would do whatever you feel is necessary. Perhaps for drachmi, or maybe to further a personal goal.
That describes a lot of people.
I suppose I'm curious why you did it. How could I not be when you're the reason my friend is being forced to leave the only home he's ever known?
I think you have the wrong person.
You are claiming that you're the wrong person? Life's one true happiness is knowing yourself.
Even if I did know who rigged the ostracism vote, I wouldn't tell you.
And yet, I never said anyone rigged anything.
Socrates, there you are.
Here I am.
You're late.
They're all waiting for you.
I wish to see Anaxagoras' fate, and so I have. Tell them I'm on my way. Well, it seemed our conversation is at its end. Although I hope it isn't the final one we have.
I wouldn't know.
That's everything Pericles wanted. Time to return to him and find out what these Athenians know about my mother.
I don't want to be spotted here.
You can't be here! Go away!
Hey, did you know they sent a new train?
We'll be watching you, Mystios.
Ah, at least give them a welcome first.
Fine. Pericles welcomes you to his symposium.
Sandra, it's you!
Phoebe!
You promised we'd see each other again, and now we have!
I also said, stay out of trouble.
Which I have! Okay, almost out of trouble.
How did you even get here, Phoebe?
Well, I did make some drachmi working for Marcos.
So you paid someone to bring you to Athens?
Not exactly.
Phoebe...
I needed a drachmi for when I arrived. I couldn't use it all to leave, and I didn't want to wait any longer. So I sneaked on a ship. Don't worry, nobody saw.
I just can't believe you made it.
I don't remember much of Athens from when I was a baby. But every once in a while, something feels familiar. It's nice.
I can't believe you're here.
Me either. I can't believe we both made it to Athens. It's so much different from Kefalonia.
But what are you doing here?
I'm here to get you ready. I have to make sure you leave all your weapons and change into these clothes.
So you somehow work here? For Pericles?
No, for Aspasia.
How is it you're working for Aspasia?
Well, I did get into a little bit of trouble after I got to Athens. I may have been a leader of a small group of orphans that tried to cheat Aspasia. We didn't know it was her, though.
And you convinced her to hire you?
No. She asked me on her own.
That was lucky. I don't understand why I have to change.
It's just what you do here. I felt weird at first, but you forget about it pretty fast.
And my weapons?
Don't worry. I'll take care of them. You don't want to scare people in there.
Well... I think I'm ready to go in.
You can't! Not like that, anyway. The Athenians like it best when you try to fit in. But don't worry, I have just the outfit for you.
I'll get changed. Promise you'll take care of my things?
Yep. Leave your weapons in the corner, and I'll come back when you're done.
I feel uncomfortable in this.
Now you look like everyone else.
You say that like it's a good thing.
It is. If you want them to take you seriously, this is the easiest way. Trust me.
Is that everything?
You're all ready to go in. Don't worry. You've done scarier things than this.
I'm struggling to think of any right now. Are you sure I can't keep just one weapon with me?
No weapons. Now hurry and go in. Oh, and don't leave without saying bye.
Here, Cassandra. The mighty mercenary and traveler has finally made her grand entrance. Only slightly late, too.
Herodotus! Athenians have no problem letting me know when I'm not welcome. It's a relief to see your friendly face.
Don't let the company here tonight intimidate you.
I won't.
Pericles is no king. He needs these guests to love him so that the people love him. And they, in turn, need Pericles. You're not different from any of them.
Do you really think these people will help me?
They will, if you get them to trust you. And you've wisely dressed for the occasion. Appearing trustworthy is the most important part of being trusted, after all. Now then, come, let me introduce you to everyone. They may not look it, but this group holds the way to the future on the tip of their opinionated tongues. Ah, Sophocles and Euripides, for example. Two of the most celebrated playwrights to date. No one can throw stones as far as they can. They appear to be locked in some kind of intellectual struggle, as is their way.
He's a writer of comedies, of all things. Comedies, Euripides!
I've heard of Sophocles. In my line of work, it pays to know who the richest and most famous men are.
Hermipos has also written his fair share of comedies.
You should drink more.
Lately, his attitudes have garnered him more notice than his works. However, the fellow beside him, Protagoras, is a sophist worthy of as much praise as the great Socrates himself.
Inviting Socrates seems like a good way to ruin everyone's night. I'm surprised they would let him in the door.
Oh, don't let Socrates get under your skin. At least he wore shoes for the occasion. And the poor thing gesticulating like an ape is Thrasymachos. If you listen closely, you'll notice he and Socrates are actually arguing the same points. But the wind from his wild gestures deafens him to critique.
That isn't at all what I mean.
Where is Pericles?
Oh, he never attends his own parties. Which reminds me, there's something I need to get his help with.
Vile Socrates! Always appearing where I least expect him. Warrior, protect me from his amorous gaze. Oh, Alcibiades, this is not a time for jealousy, but for love.
Let's not use Alcibiades as an example. Be good, and don't drink too much. So, tell me, what does a Mystios like you think of a party like this?
This is going to be a long night. Parties should be about vomiting up blood, not vomiting up poetry. These people are so clean.
If these guests aren't to your own unique tastes, then just focus on why you came here in the first place.
Thank you, Herodotus.
Now, if you'll excuse me, Pericles is here somewhere, and I need to prepare him. If he's alone, I'll tell him what your brother said.
You're leaving me alone with these people?
You'll do fine without me, I promise. Just relax, talk to the others, and focus on finding your mother.
Yes, you come and talk to this infuriating air blocker. I've had my fill.
Perhaps later. First, explain to me your point of view. And so it isn't the rich and powerful, but the gods who are the source of justice?
What? No! Have you been listening to nothing I say?
I suppose you've come in here to mock me for my fight with Euripides.
Spare me. I'm only looking for clues to help me find a Spartan woman.
A Spartan woman in Athens. Sounds intriguing. Though, if you expect me to notice someone other than myself, you expect too much. You could talk to Euripides. He's the second most worldly man here. That pediculous, Xanthodontus exothalmic Morosov. But he doesn't talk without a drink.
I have no idea what that meant.
No, you don't.
You want to get Evripides drunk? Are you hoping he's gonna make an even bigger scene than you did?
Ha! We both know that's not possible. But you're a feisty one, to say the least.
All right. If nothing else, this party could use the help.
You'll need to pick the right wine for this task. The kitchen should have what you need. Let me know when Evripides is done in, and I'll slip away unseen.
How do you know Pericles?
I believe you mean to ask me, how does Pericles know you? I'm the greatest dramatist in the land, mentor to Evripides, lover of Asclepios, father of theater, and so on, and so on.
I'm sure it's a real honor to have you hiding in his kitchen. You're awfully worked up over Evripides. You sure you're just friends?
I'm never just anything, foreigner. Though I confess, Evripides and I hold a bond deeper than brotherhood. Why he slams it with that banal young plaything, Aristophanes, I will never know.
I'll get the wine.
Wonderful. Now, if you want some friendly advice, Aristophanes cannot stand sweet wine. I've seen what it can do to him. Absolutely, horrifyingly delightful.
It wouldn't be a party without someone losing their stomach. I'll let you know if your plan worked.
Save for that arrogant playwright. I don't see many distinguished guests in here. Can I help you with something?
I'm here for your sweet wine.
Yes, take it. But get out of my kitchen. I'm very busy, you know.
A new face in Pericles' abode! Ha! That in itself is a remarkable thing. You must have seen me doing my impression of Cleon. I call it the Orange Ape. Tell me, what does it think?
I am called many things. It isn't one of them.
What do you call yourself then? Creature of many names?
Cassandra.
I wouldn't peg you as a Cassandra, but never mind. I'm Aristophanes, and this man is Evripides. Oh, go on, introduce yourself.
I'm Evripides.
For a playwright, you're not much for words.
Good men lead quiet lives, as old Evripides likes to say. Don't you, Evripides?
When I need to relax, I start a fight. For you, though.
Quickly! Bring him some wine so that he might say something clever.
After my argument with Sophocles, I think I'd rather keep my head clear.
I'm Pericles' new servant. I'd be happy to bring some wine.
An Athenian servant, you. And these are wine-pouring muscles.
I was a rower on Pericles' ship where he took pity on me. Now I pour wine for people who question my word. And his.
I wasn't questioning. Perhaps one drink.
Pericles has invited all of you here for some reason.
Either we dine here and praise Pericles, or we dine with Cleon. But Cleon has all the charm of a typical politician. A horrible voice, bad breathing, and vulgar manners.
Why don't you just apologize to Sophocles?
It's he who should apologize to you.
Sophocles is a friend, and one good friend is worth an entire family. He just needs time to recover from his outburst.
I'm only here because I'm searching for someone.
And yet it gave us the distinct impression it was here to fill our wine. Let's focus on that first, shall we?
Let's conjure Dionysos, shall we?
This is pure swill.
Amateur. In my day, this would be considered nectar of the gods. Another round!
Ready for more?
Yeah, I can hardly stomach this pig's piss.
I could outdrink both of you with one hand. Let's have some more.
You ready for another?
This wine is terrible.
You, I like you. Who brought you here?
I brought myself. I'm on the trail of a woman who fled Sparta a long time ago.
Fled? Why?
She lost two children. She had no choice.
She fled to heal a broken heart. Euripides, write her into a play.
I've heard Spartan mothers go to a sanctuary in Argolis to beg Asclepios for his divine pity. I should know, it's my home.
After what she went through, I'm not sure she'd trust priests.
Then she sought my friend, Hippocrates. He's a physician, best of the best. He still keeps his office in Argos. If she went to him for help, there's no doubt he'd have given it.
I love getting drunk and singing. Come back if you want to sing with me.
I'll think about it. Hippocrates in Argos. Here I come.
Ah, the mystios from the ostracism. Let's talk later.
How's Euripides? Drunk, I hope.
You can stop hiding in here. Euripides won't notice you coming out. He won't notice anything.
Hiding? Heed this. War has come to Athens. First they take our homes, then they take our heads. I intend to be found with at least my dignity intact. Or what's left of it anyway. If you see Pericles, tell him I said thank you for another colorful evening.
Dionysos, there you are. Everyone else here is boring.
Let's play a singing game. You like to sing? You like to sing.
Let's do this.
I want to play too, but who should start?
I think you should, Aristophanes.
Fine, fine. But let's do a good one.
A battle song?
Is there any other kind?
The flick of a limb comes Aspasia's whim, and Pericles' walls aim to contain us all within.
What Spartan families lose, they lose for duty. When Spartan fathers refuse, they refuse beauty.
But the dangerous part are the Athenian darts, who go for the meat when they should go for the heart.
Oh, so bring your merchants and bring their butlers. If they be sons, they bring their fathers. This is war, war, war.
Bring your murderers to the crimson quiver. Bring the helots if they be spillers. It is war, war, war.
War is tough. The more we fight, the more
we love. Let the juices flow from heart to spear. We have nothing to fear when death is near. Our bodies bring with them nothing they hold dear.
The stupid sweepers, the genius teachers, all just meats and juice and liver.
For when our wars are done, after lives are lost and blood has run, we must rejoin our broken daughters and our sons. Reunited together, we will be one.
That was awful. I'm not sure you even know how to sing.
We might be too drunk. That was the worst song I ever heard.
We should find Hippocrates in Argos, for sure.
Oh!